My name is Rachel D'Souza and I'm the Children's Commissioner for England. The last year has been really challenging for children in so many ways. It's been incredible what you've done to help stop the spread of the coronavirus, like not seeing your friends or your relatives, or learning from home instead of school. Missing out on playing out or going to after school clubs, sports and activities, and even losing family members to COVID. It's been really tough, but you've got through it. Now you're back to school and things are going to start getting back to normal.
I'm actually very happy about coming back to school, finally get to see all my friends and, you know, their faces again instead of looking at them on screen. It's more like natural, and also I need to get prepared for my A-levels because I'm aspiring to be an aerospace engineer, right? And it's going to take me a lot of work to get there.
So it's time for the adults to listen to you about what this year has been like. When you're a child, lots of different people make decisions that affect your life. Your parents or carers might make decisions with you about what time you go to bed or what time you have to come in from seeing your friends. But there are other people who make decisions about your life too, and you might never meet them. Some of these people work for government. For example, government makes decisions about what you study at school or what support you can get if things aren't going well. My job as Children's Commissioner for England is to check that government understands how the decisions they are making about you will affect you. And it's my responsibility to make sure that people who work in the government know what you think about the plans they're making for you. I do this in different ways. The first thing I do is to talk to children and young people.
I think lockdown really motivated my passion even more for wildlife conservation. It's something I wanted to do at university because, as many people did, I went for walks over lockdown to get fresh air and because it was one of the few things you could still do.
Lockdown has affected mine and many other people, including my friends, mental health quite badly. I think that being locked up in your room, isolated, away from all of your friends, can be quite stressful and like demotivating, especially as online learning can never replace the interactive face-to-face element when you're in school and seeing all your friends, seeing your teachers in person.
To be able to live and lead a good and successful life and being able to get on the property ladder, as it's something that young people our age are probably quite concerned about, and maybe in the next 10 years, is it something we'll be able to achieve?
I am your eyes and ears, and I'm here to stand up for your rights. I'm independent of government. This means if sometimes I don't agree with the plans government is making for children, I tell them. That's because I work for you, not the government. The first thing I'm doing as Children's Commissioner is carrying out the largest ever survey of children in England. It's time to give something big back to children in England, and we need your help to do it. What is life like for you? What are your dreams and ambitions? What is holding you back?
The things that are holding me back in life is that I can be quite shy and I don't have the skills yet.
When I'm older, I would like to be a doctor, maybe a surgeon.
When I leave school, I would like to be an army officer.
My aspiration when I'm older is to be a top hairdresser.
I want to be a teacher when I grow up.
If you don't go to school, we don't get jobs. Education is really important.
Good education is really important because you need to follow things in life. If you have a dream, then you should follow it always.
Life is hard at the moment because I don't get to see all my family.
Coming back to school is hard because I have lots of work to catch up on.
Lockdown's been really boring and it's been a struggle to learn.
I'm going to use what you tell me to show the government what you need to live happier lives. It's called the Big Ask, and it's a chance to think big and get your voice heard. I promise to listen and would ask you all to take this opportunity to take our survey. But of course, I think it's a great idea. So don't just take my word for it. Here's footballer and children's champion, Marcus Rashford.
Hi guys, just a quick message to let you know that if you're asked to participate in the Big Ask, I feel like it's a great chance for you guys to have your own say, really. You know, you can voice your opinions on what's been happening and speak on what you want to happen next. So I feel like it's a brilliant way to express yourselves.